Hello friend, in this program I'm going to perform a Java string search operation over a sentence. Let me show you the output first, that what exactly you need to do. First you have to input a sentence like you are nice, and then it is asking to enter the search word, and that is R, and it will tell me where exactly the word is present if the search condition matches. In this kind of program there is often a tendency to consider the blank space. That what student often do, but that to some extent lead to an error. Why? Let me show you, because not necessary that your input will always start with a letter. It can be even a blank space. Like this is a scenario, I've given a blank space over here and then I'm inputting you are nice. So in that case also it is going to give me the output 2. It might even occur that your initial start with a blank space and then you provide extra blank space over here and then you are writing the word that you want to search, then also the output is going to be 2. So starting, there can be ample number of blank space in between the two words, there can be ample blank space. So in all these cases you have to ignore the blank space and consider the exact location where your word is present. So how you need to do this? So at first what I have done, let me show you execution. I have taken the input from the user, the string, and I have taken the search word even, and I have stored it over here, and now I am executing a for loop. In this for loop, the very initial thing what I have done is I need to check whether the starting letters are blank space or not, and that's the reason this particular if statement does the work. It says that if I equal to 0, I equal to 0 means this particular initialization is consideration, and this will be working for the first time because the ith value will be 0 only for the first initial iteration, and after that it will get incremented. And then it is considering that the content of STRI, which is 0th position, if it is not a blank space. Like in this case, it is a blank space, so this is not true. But in this case, it is not a blank space. See, the initial started with the letter itself. So it is considering that if it is a 0th position, here the condition is to 0th position, and if it is not a blank space, like in this case, it is not a blank space, then the count is going to be incremented. But in this case, this is not going to happen because even though it is a 0th position, but the initial is a blank space, so this count will not be incremented in that case, right? This is a counter which I will be using to count number of word later on to find out in which position the word is. So this if condition, after getting executed, the next if condition will also be evaluated. Is check that the str dot caret, the I, which is the 0th position, is equal to quote or not. Like over here, if it is quote, this is considered, this particular iteration is checked, decision making is checking for the subsequent blank spaces in between the word. So if there is subsequent blank space, that means if the first character is a blank space, suppose this particular character is a blank space, and then following to that character is blank space or not, that means I'm considering the upcoming characters are blank space or not. If it is not, then only the count will be incremented. Okay, so these two conditions are going to play a very crucial role in checking up whether your subsequent characters are blank space or not. And then I'm taking up, going to form this particular word. For that what I'm doing is that if it is not a blank space, like when you are going for this U, first y is been considered, which is not a blank space, then I'm extracting the y and I'm storing in the variable ch, and then I'm initializing that to the another string variable str2, and then I'm literally comparing it. But since it's just y, so my search criteria was r, so very naturally this is not going to be true, right? So in this case again the thing would move forward, and over here see it is not a blank space right now because your input is y, so this particular if condition is not going true. The reason of using this if condition is, like, once this particular word gets stored into my array, into this particular string variable, and then after comparison between this word and the search criteria, if it does matches or does not matches, I need to remove this content of the string variable so that the next word can be stored inside the same variable. If I retain the previous content, then the search criteria will never match because it will be the concatenation of multiple string into the same array. So each time when your search word, whether matching or not matching, it is responsibility of the programmer to remove that particular content of the array so that the search can continue. And for doing so, you have to check whether there is a blank space or not, then only you will be removing it. Or in the same thing over here also, if it is not a blank space, then you will keep on storing it into the string variable, and then In this way, the first, suppose in case of u, the first y got stored, then y, u o got stored. That means concatenation of y and o, and then u got stored. That means the entire word u is there, and this u and is been compared with the search criteria that is r, which I have given over here. It's been compared, and the condition is not true, so this part didn't work. And then that time the u will be removed by virtue of this, because the next subsequent character is a blank space, so the u will be removed. In this way, again it will keep on moving. And then finally it will come to the R part. So again the R word, letter A, will be stored inside this string. And then AR will be stored, AR will be stored, then E will be stored in this way. The entire ARE will be stored, and then again ARE is compared with the search criteria. At that point of time it matches over here, the message will be prompted that the search criteria is true, and it will also show you the location in which the word is there, and then it will clear off. And then it will initialize the flag variable y. This is used to check whether the string exists or not. Like there might be a situation where the search criteria does not exist. For example, let me show you that. You are nice, and I'm giving the word r as a misspelled double e, which is not there into my string, and it says the search is not valid. And in this particular program, you can even search multiple times as well. Suppose I have written you are, I'm giving a multiple space over here, sweet and you are nice, and I'm searching the word r, which is there in twice. Just see the location. Even this is the second word, third, fourth and fifth, and this is sixth word. So in spite of the fact that there are extra blank space also, then also that is considered, and it's giving me the appropriate output. And if the word is not existing in this, then in that case the variable flag, which has been initialized at the very beginning as n, will remain n, and then the search is not valid, that will be shown. So from this particular program, one thing got very clear, that you cannot just use a blank space as an off whenever you desire, but you have to come up with the proper choice, because your starting characters can be your letter, starting characters can be your blank space, there can be infinite number of blank space in between. So all this consideration need to be taken care of, and these are the two decision making which will give you the appropriate output. Okay, so this was the program. Thank you very much.